Hey, what's up guys? It's Adam, and here is my PSPi version 4 board. So I'm going to do an overview of all the features, but first, here's a quick summary of the project. This all started a few years ago when the Pi Zero came out. People started putting them in Game Boys to make emulation machines. I really liked the idea, but I wanted something with a bigger screen and a better feel, so I gave it a try on the PSP. The first couple versions had some insane wiring. Version 1 was the first attempt, and I didn't document much of the process because I was still figuring it out. Version 2, though, was a little more polished, and I documented everything on the RetroPie forum and on my own website. And you can check out links 1 and 2 in the description below. While I was working on version 2, some articles were written about it, and that drove a lot of traffic to my website. People started asking for a circuit board to take the place of the rat's nest, so I decided to give it a try. I started simple with what I called version 2.1, and then I moved on to version 3, which is link 3 in the description. I was able to combine most of the important stuff on version 3, like power and audio, but it still used a composite LCD. This worked just fine, but it kind of reduced battery life and also ran pretty hot. The version 3 board is the first one that I really mass produced. I built each one by hand, which was pretty tedious, but I did a decent job keeping up with demand. And once demand slowed down, I moved on to version 4. I made version 4 to be as drop-in as possible in the PSP, and packed as much into it as I could at the time. Like with version 3, I also built every one of these by hand. There were just too many odd components that couldn't be assembled in a factory. I couldn't keep up with demand for this board though, and decided to open source everything. That's what I'm gonna do going forward with my projects. Getting away from assembling and shipping, and instead making open source projects, and then moving on to the next one. All right, on to the version 4 board. I'm gonna break it up into groups, starting with battery and power. I designed the whole battery setup using pretty standard components. The connector is just a normal JST, which you'll find on lots of single cell LiPo batteries. And I found a Turnigy battery that fits really well into the PSP battery compartment, and it has a pretty high capacity. For battery charging, I added a genuine PSP power connector, so you can use the PSP charging cable. As for electronics, the battery charger is the common TP4056. It's used in all sorts of things to charge lithium batteries at up to an amp. It's got LED indicators, so I routed those to the PSP's dual color LED, so it turns from green to orange when the battery's charging. It also turns green when the battery's fully charged, even if the PSP is fully powered off. There's also some voltage sensing on the board, but I'll cover that in a later section. I added battery protection using another pretty common chip, which is the DW01, and that just gets paired with the dual MOSFET. It keeps the battery from being overcharged, over-discharged, or short-circuited. Here are some schematics if anyone's curious. There's also a couple emergency features built in. Since the board can sense battery voltage, the OS can do a shutdown if the battery reaches a critical level. There's also a hardwired emergency circuit that totally kills power before it reaches a level that could cause issues with the Raspberry Pi. That circuit's really simple. It just uses an LM393 to compare the battery voltage to a stable reference voltage. The Pi doesn't have any soft on-off circuits built in, so those were added to the board. The circuit I used is based off one from Mosaic Industries. It's able to switch on using a momentary push button, which the PSP has on its slide switch. Once that button's pressed, the circuit powers the Pi and the board for about 3 seconds. Within those 3 seconds, the Pi has to begin booting and then switch the state of a pin, and if that doesn't happen, the power turns off automatically. This can happen if the SD card isn't in the Pi, or if the Pi is malfunctioning in some way. This pin on the Raspberry Pi also handles power off during a shutdown. When the Pi finishes shutting down, the GPIO pin switches states again on the power circuit and kills power to the entire board. The circuit also has a second feature that lets you kill power without shutting the Pi down. If needed, you can hold the momentary push button for about 3 seconds, and that will kill power to the board. Another difference between this board and the version 3 is the way power is sent to the Pi. With version 3, the power went through a boost converter and increased the voltage up to 5 volts. This was done mostly because the composite LCD needed at least 5 volts in order to work properly. This was unnecessary in version 4 though, because everything runs off 3.3 volt or less. As long as the battery stays above 3.3 volts, the Pi works just fine. This one change increased efficiency by probably about 10%, so that reduced heat a little and gave a little more playtime. Alright guys, my monotone voice and this boring content is probably knocking you out, so I'm going to go ahead and cut the video off here. The next part is going to cover the audio and the LCD circuits, and I'll have that up in a few days. Thanks for watching, and please leave feedback in the comments.